Hello students, we have already started third lesson, that is the force and pressure. Up to this we have discussed about the force, units of force, types of force. Then we have discussed about the effects of force, inertia and types of inertia. So in that way we have finished first part of the lesson, that is the force. Now we are going to learn another next concept of the lesson, that is a pressure. So first of all we will see what is mean by pressure. Now for this I will do some activity first. You observe that carefully, okay, and try to understand. Now what is this? This is the iron nail and this is a wooden plank, okay. Now, I will try to fix this nail into this wooden plank, and for that, I am hammering on the head of the nail. Okay? And see what happened. You will observe that it is very easy to fix the nail into the wooden plank. Now see another case. Now I will hammer on the pointed end of the nail and I will try to fix that nail into the plank. You will observe that it is not able to fix the nail into the plank by hammering on its pointed end. Okay. Now see the next example. This is a fruit. Okay. Now this is a knife. आपण घरी चाकू वापरतो, फळ भाज्या कापण्यासाठी किंवा चाकू, ओके, नाईफ. दिस इज अ शार्प एंड ऑफ द नाईफ, व्हेअरएज दिस इज अ ब्लंट एंड ऑफ द नाईफ. ओके, हा कसा आहे? शार्प आहे आणि हा कसा आहे? बोटट आहे, ब्लंट आहे. नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आय विल ट्राय टू कट द फ्रूट विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस अँड यू विल ऑब्झर्व दॅट it is not able to cut the fruit by using this blunt end. Okay, on the other hand, if I will try to cut the fruit by using its sharp end, you will observe that now very easily it is pierced into the fruit and fruit is easily cut with the help of this knife. Okay, this is the second example. Okay, now see next example. I will take this pencil and I will keep this pencil in between my two fingers, that is the middle finger and the forefinger. I will press on both sides. Okay, I am exerting a force by both the fingers on this pencil. See what happens. You are observing. Okay, my both fingers, that is a thumb and forefinger. There is a, see, sign of the pencil. It goes deep. This is the sharp end. And this sharp end, we can say, immerse into the finger deeply as compared to my thumb. Okay. In all these examples, one thing is, similar, that is, when the force is exerted, same force is exerted on the larger area, the effect of force, that is a less. On the other hand, if the sharp end is there, the effect of force is more. See one more example. You stand on the sand for 10 minutes, okay, and for the next 10 minutes you sleep on that sand for 10 minutes. What you will observe? When you stand on the sand, at that time you go deep into the sand. Okay? Whereas, there is no any impression you will observe on the sand when you sleep for 10 minutes. Okay? Now see all these examples. What it indicates? So what is the pressure? Pressure is nothing but the force exerted perpendicularly on unit area. बरोबर आहे. एकक पृष्ठभागावरती लंब दिशेने जे बल प्रयुक्त होतो त्याला आपण म्हणतो प्रेशर किंवा दाब. ओके, सो व्हॉट इज प्रेशर? फोर्स एक्झर्टेड परपेंडिक्युलरली ऑन युनिट एरिया. एकक पृष्ठभागावरती लंब जे बल प्रयुक्त होतं त्याला आम्ही दाब किंवा प्रेशर असं म्हणतो. ठीक आहे. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस वी कॅन से दॅट प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू फोर्स बाय एरिया. इज दॅट क्लिअर? प्रेशर दॅट इज इक्वल टू फोर्स बाय एरिया. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस वी कॅन से दॅट प्रेशर इज डायरेक्टली प्रपोर्शनल टू फोर्स, whereas it is inversely proportional to area. Okay, when the force is increased the pressure is also increased, and when the force is decreased the pressure is also decreased. So force and pressure, they are directly proportional. On the other hand, when the area is increased, in this example we have seen, if the area is increased that means we was hammering on pointed edge. At that time, the effect of pressure that will be less. So when the area is increased, the pressure is decreased. Okay? In all the examples you have seen, when the pressure is increased, sorry, area is increased, pressure is decreased. So this is about the force. So what is meant by pressure? Sorry, pressure that is a force exerted perpendicularly on unit area. Force is directly proportional to pressure. Okay, and pressure is inversely proportional to area. Now we know the units of force in SI and how area is measured, that you know. Now you suppose the SI unit of force is Newton and area is measured in meter square, so we can say that the unit of pressure, that is a Newton per meter square. What is it? Newton per meter square. Yes, SI unit of pressure, that is Newton per meter square. This is also known as Pascal and it is denoted by capital P with small a. यालाच आम्ही पास्कल असं सुद्धा म्हणतो. त्या शास्त्रज्ञाचं नाव दिलेलं आहे पास्कल. ओके, सो पास्कल दॅट इज डिनोटेड बाय कॅपिटल पी विथ स्मॉल ए. In atmospheric science, it is also known as bar, and 1 bar that is equal to 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Okay, now see some another activities. Now this is a bottle which is filled with water. ही पाण्याने भरलेली बाटली आपण बघतोय. आता पाण्याने भरलेली जी बाटली आहे याच्यामध्ये आपण पाहतो द वॉटर विच इज फिल्ड इन द बॉटल that exerts the pressure on the sides of the bottle as well as it exerts pressure at the bottom of the bottle also. आपण या बाटलीमध्ये पाणी भरलंय, ह्याच्यामध्ये भरलेलं पाणी या बाटलीच्या बाजूंवरती प्रेशर एक्झर्ट करतं किंवा दाब निर्माण करतं आणि त्याच वेळेला त्या बाटलीच्या बॉटमवरती सुद्धा ते दाब निर्माण करतं. वी नो दॅट द फोर्स इज प्रेशर इज एक्झर्टेड when the fluids, okay, they are taken in a container, they exert a pressure on the container in which they are stored. Now another example, see, this is a balloon. Now I fill air in this. Now air is filled in this balloon and the air which is present in the balloon, that exerts the pressure on the balloon equally. Okay, so water, that is a liquid and gases, collectively they are known as the fluids. Gases and liquids commonly called as fluids and they exert pressure on all sides in which they are taken, in which they are stored. Okay, one thing is clear. Okay, now see the another example. Now this is a bottle. Okay, I will fill water in this bottle. See, I You will observe that the water is coming out in the form of jet from this opening. See, one more opening I made here below this opening. Okay, and one more opening is here. Now you will observe that the water jet which is coming out from the bottle, it indicates that the water exerting pressure on the sides of the bottle. Okay, and the pressure is more at the lower side as compared to upper side. So this is also one more example. Okay, where you are observing that the water jet is coming out from the bottle as water exert pressure on the sides of the bottle. Now see one more example. Now this is a bottle. I made one hole to this bottle. Okay, and then one balloon it is fitted on that tube. And now I will fill the water in this bottle. See what happened. As the hole is very fine, you will observe that the water coming out from the opening. Okay, if you keep one balloon here, you will observe that. See, now see what is happening here. Water, this balloon is now water. See, this is the water jet coming out from the water. Okay. So from these examples, if you fill the balloon with air, if you fill balloon with water, okay, what will happen? The balloon will inflate. Sorry, see this one. What happened? Fuga ka thala hai. Paana mati ke fugla hai. Mujhse kya thala hai? Paana ne jitna pressure exert ke. Okay. So fluids, that is the gases and liquids, they exert a pressure on the container in which they are stored. So this is about the pressure that we have to learn. Is that clear? What is pressure? Pressure mane kya padhi the pressure ami dab asa mantu. Pressure, that is a force exerted perpendicularly on unit area. Ekak prushthabhagavarti lamba rupat aslela jo dab. Sorry. जो बल आपण आहे तर ब्रेक पे त्याला आपण म्हणतो दाब. त्यानंतर आपण पाहिलं प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू फोर्स बाय एरिया. दाब बरोबर आहे बल भागिले एरियाला. आम्ही काय म्हणू? यस करेक्ट. सो फोर्स बाय एरिया. सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कॅन से दॅट प्रेशर दॅट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फोर्स. And it is inversely proportional to area. Then we are seeing the units of pressure. That is a newton per meter square. It is also known as a Pascal. How it is denoted? Pascal is denoted by capital P with small a. Okay? It is also, in atmospheric science, it is also known as bar. And one bar is nothing but the 10^5 Pascal. Then we are seeing that the gases and liquids, they are commonly called fluids, and fluids exert pressure in which they are stored. Okay. Now we see next concept, that is the atmospheric pressure. You are familiar with this. You have learned that the envelope of gases, it is present around the earth. And that envelope of gases, that is known as a atmosphere. Okay. Now we'll see some example to see this atmospheric pressure. Now when we are in standing position, at that time a column of air, it is present on our head, and then also we do not get crushed. आपल्यावरती एवढा मोठा ऍटमॉस्फिअर प्रेशर आहे. आपण म्हटलं की समुद्र सपाटीपासून जसजसं आपण वर जातो ऍटमॉस्फिअरिक प्रेशर जे आहे ते कमी कमी होत जातं, आणि पृथ्वीच्या जवळ जवळजवळ 40 ते 30 किलोमीटर अंतरापर्यंत आपण बघतो की ऍटमॉस्फिअरिक प्रेशर आहे. पण एवढं प्रेशर असताना सुद्धा आम्ही काय होतो, क्रश होते. त्याचं रिझन आहे आपल्या बॉडीमध्ये सुद्धा वेगवेगळे फ्लुइड्स आहेत, आणि ते फ्लुइड्स सुद्धा काय करतात, अपोजिंग प्रेशर तिथे एक्झर्ट करतात आणि दोघं नलिफाय होतात आणि म्हणून आम्ही क्रश होत नाही. नो सी, टेल मी व्हॉट इज दिस, तुम्हाला भीती वाटते याची? आहे इंजेक्शनची सिरिंज. ही अशी असते, थोडीशी छोटी आपण बघतोय, आणि इथे सुई आहे. सुई पण कशी असते, शार्प असते इंजेक्शनची, जी आपल्याला आधी कळत नाही, थोडीशी जाड होते. बरोबर आहे, तिथे पण तेच आहे. एरिया लहान, ती तितकी सहजतेने आत जाऊ शकते. ओके, सो दिस इज अ सिरिंज. नाउ सी हाउ इट वर्क्स. तुम्ही रंगपंचमीच्या वेळेस रंग खेळता तेव्हा पिचकारी पण असंच असते. साधा एक मेटॅलिक सिलेंडर असतो, त्याच्यामध्ये एक रॉड असतो, तसंच इथं पण आहे. सपोज इज अ मेटॅलिक सिलेंडर, त्याच्यामध्ये एक रॉड असतो आणि त्याला एक पिस्टन लावलेलं असतं खालच्या बाजूला. आता पहिल्यांदा डॉक्टर काय करतात, जेव्हा याच्यामध्ये इंजेक्शन घ्यायचं त्याच्या आधी असं करून घेतात, टू रिमूव द एअर विच इज प्रेझेंट इन द आउटर ट्यूब, ग्लास ट्यूब. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेन इट इज पुश इन साइड, ऍट दॅट टाइम द एअर विच इज प्रेझेंट इन द ट्यूब इट इज रिमूव, अँड लेटर ऑन इट इज डीप इन टू द इंजेक्शन बॉटल. सो ऍट दॅट टाइम स्लोली द पिस्टन इज टेकन बॅक. बघा काय होतं, इथे मागच्या बाजूला काही चालू आहे आणि इथे आपण पाहतोय की या सिरीजमध्ये आता काय झालंय, इंजेक्शन आहे. आणि आता उलटं केलं तरी पण हे खाली पडत नाही, त्याचं कारण काय असेल? देअर इज अ डिफरन्स बिटवीन द प्रेशर इनर अँड आउटर. नाउ द ऍटमॉस्फिअरिक प्रेशर इज मोर ॲज कम्पेअर टू इनर प्रेशर, अँड ॲज अ रिझल्ट काय होतं की खाली पडत नाही. Okay, it cannot fall down as there is a lot of pressure from the outside, that is atmospheric pressure. Now when it is inserted into the body of the patient, at that time slowly now it is injected into the patient body. Now why this happens now? Okay, now at this time the pressure is more at the inner side, and we are pushing this piston. Because of that reason, it comes out. And in that way, the syringe, it works on that basis, that is atmospheric pressure. Now see the next example. You know what is this? This is a dropper. Okay? But shy vartana kaya kato, when we have to fill the ink into the pen, at that time, first of all, we press this bulb. Rubber bulb is here at one end, another end is narrow somewhat, and this is a glass tube. Now first of all we press this bulb, at that time the air which is present in this tube, that is removed, and later on it is deep into the ink, and then slowly we remove the pressure from the bulb. So what will happen? The ink is entered into the bulb. This is also due to difference between the pressure. Now the atmospheric pressure on the ink which is present in the beaker, that is more as compared to dropper. And as the ink is entered into the dropper. Okay. So this also works on the basis of atmospheric pressure. So have you understand? Okay, what is pressure, what is the unit of pressure, okay, what is bar, 1 bar is equal to 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Then we have studied that gases and liquids commonly called as fluids. Fluids exert pressure in which they are stored. Then atmospheric pressure is the pressure exerted by air. Okay. And then we have seen the working of the syringe and the ink dropper. Clear? Okay. Now see all the activities and try to do all this activity at your home. Okay. And enjoy the learning. Okay, we'll stop here. Thank you.